All right, Jennifer, as cases of coronavirus mount, hospital emergency departments are feeling the strain and asking people to stay away if possible. Join us today in this week's Doctor on Call is Dr. Philip Oblinger, TriHealth Systems Chief for Emergency Medicine. You're a busy man these days.
Well, thank you for having me.
We're glad to have you here. Let's start with that. You don't want people to stay away if they do need emergency care.
No, we don't. And certainly these are unprecedented and challenging and unnerving times that we're living in right now. But I would like to assure our community that our emergency departments within TriHealth, our hospitals in TriHealth, and all of our hospitals in the area have been diligently preparing for this. And my personal and professional opinion, and those of similar experts, believe that we're better prepared for this than any community that's facing it.
Really? When you say any community, in the United States, in the world?
In any community that has so far had this attack them.
Okay.
And you know, the other important thing to remember is that we're going to get through this, and
sure,
we're going to end up as a stronger individuals and community on the other side. From the point of view of the emergency department, things are a little different. So if you have to come to the emergency department, it'll seem a little different. You can't, all of the hospitals have requirements not to bring visitors unless, of course,
sure,
it's a minor, or there's special exceptions. You may come in and they may immediately put a mask on you, which is not usual.
Sure.
And you'll notice that we've taken a lot of precautions to protect our patients from each other and to protect ourselves as well. So you'll see a lot more personal protective equipment on staff. So it's a little bit different and a little bit different feel. But it is important to remember that if you have a true emergency, you still should go to the emergency department. And all of our area emergency departments are ready and willing and able to take care of those other emergencies.
So when we say that you're feeling a strain, there's not a strain in terms of getting people in to deal with their emergencies as of now, and do you foresee one in the next couple of weeks?
We will have a surge, and all of the efforts that have been made to dampen that surge, I think, will work. So our surge may not be like they've seen in Washington or New York, but we will see a surge.
And
right now, we have not seen that.
Okay. Really quickly, Jennifer and her Facebook group have been making masks to help with secondary people. This is not something you would wear.
Well, and you know, this is a great example of just the overwhelming support we've gotten from the community, from industry bringing us N95 masks, to people making masks like this to cover N95 masks to make them last longer.
And it does help at the hospitals for receptionists, secondary.
Absolutely,
workers.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
We're still exploring who can appropriately use a cloth mask, but for example, in the protection of an N95 mask, there's definitely some room for that.
So. Excellent.
And we appreciate all the thoughts.
I have 10 seconds.
Yes.
Do you have any concerns for your health covering this?
I think we're pretty well prepared, and as long as we have adequate personal protective equipment, which we do, everybody's concerned for their health, probably no more so than the average person.
If I may, we're having you and all your staff and all of our people on the first line in prayer right now, and we know you got this, you trained for this, and thank you.
Well, thank you.
All right, we'll be right back with the last check of your weather in just a moment.